टुडे टॉपिक इज पॉइजन फार्मूला। पॉइजन फार्मूला यूज सॉल्यूशन इन द रैप्ड सिग्मा प्लेन फॉर सर्कल एंड लाइन। एज वी नो दैट द काशी इंटीग्रल फार्मूला इज एफ ऑफ सी इज इक्वल टू 1/2 pi आई कंटोर ऑफ सी एफ ऑफ एस ओवर एस माइनस जी टी एस, वेयर एफ ऑफ सी इज एनालिटिक इन एंड ऑन सर्कल क्लोज कंटोर विच सॉल्यूशन पॉइंट इज जी। The solution to Laplace equation in Z plane is also a solution in sigma plane. We will suppose our unit circle Z is equal to e raised to power iota theta. Next topic is the Dirichlet problem for a circle. To describe the Dirichlet problem for a circle, we will consider the problem of solving Laplace equation in a circular region r less than and equal to a. Our radius is less than and equal to a. Subject to the boundary condition u of a theta is equal to f of theta. On the boundary of circle, our function is u of a theta, where a is radius and theta is the angle. Where f is a given function on theta 0 to 2 pi because the circle angle is 0 to 2 pi. We draw a circle xy axis where a is a radius and theta is a angle. U of a theta is equal to f of theta. It is the value of a boundary. In polar coordinates, Laplace equation has the form delta square u is equal to 0. So delta square u is equal to u double r mean double derivative of u with respect to r plus 1 over r u r plus 1 over r square u double theta. In the polar coordinate Laplace equation, delta square u is equal to 0, where u must be a periodic is theta with period 2 pi and u r theta is bounded for r less than and equal to a. Now by using the Laplace equation, we will describe the Poisson formula. So to describe the Poisson formula, let f of z is equal to u plus iota v such that u is equal to real function of f of z. Also for some z1 greater than 1. Now we know that for z our function is contour along a circle. Now we take another point, it's z1, it is outside the circle. We can see that z is a point who lie inside the circle and z1 is another point which is lie outside the circle. We will discuss the Cauchy integral formula for both these points. When we apply z1 in Cauchy integral formula, we have 1 over 2 pi I along a contour c f of s over s minus z is equal to z1 ds. Now we can see that our z1 point is outside the circle. So outside the circle function is non-analytic, that way it is equal to 0. So how can we take this equation inside the circle? To take this equation inside the circle, we will look at the inverse of z1 at some point z in the circle. We will let the z1 inverse, which will take the point z in the circle. So z is equal to r e raised to power iota theta, where condition is r less than and equal to 1. We will let z1 is equal to 1 over z module, and 1 over z module is equal to 1 over r e raised to power iota theta. Now by using this value in this equation, we will describe the Cauchy integral formula. So f of z is equal to, by combining Cauchy integral formula for function z and z1, we have f of z is equal to 1 over 2 pi I c f of s into 1 over s minus z1 minus f over s minus z ds. On the unit circle, we have s is equal to e raised to power iota phi. So when we differentiate it, we have ds is equal to iota e raised to power iota phi is equal to iota is as it is, iota phi is equal to s. Just put the value in above equation. We have f of z is equal to 1 over 2 pi I 0 to 2 pi, because the circle angle is 0 to 2 pi. F of s 1 over s minus z minus 1 over s minus z1, and ds is equal to iota s. Iota s d of phi. So f of z is equal to 1 over 2 pi I 0 to 2 pi f of s 1 over s minus z1 minus z minus 1 over s minus z1 iota s d of phi. Iota cancel out with iota, so we have 1 over 2 pi 0 to 2 pi f of s, and this function as it is f d of phi. Now just put z1 is equal to, because we take z1 is inverse, so just put the value of z1 in the place of z1. So we have s over s minus z1 is equal to 1 over z conjugate. 1 over 2 pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi f of s dot s over s minus z minus s over. We will take the LCM of this numerator. We have z conjugate of s minus 1 into dividing by conjugate. If we have dvn over dvn, then we can take it out in numerator. So we have s into z conjugate over z conjugate into s minus 1. When we take the s common from denominator, we have s z conjugate over s into z bar minus 1 over s. So s cancel out with s, we have z bar over z bar minus s bar. When we have s minus z, so we will convert it into form of s minus s bar minus z bar. We will take the negative sign common, then after taking the negative sign common, negative into negative plus, so we have s minus s bar minus z bar over z bar over s minus z bar into d of phi. Now we will take the LCM of this function. So we have, by taking the LCM of this function, is s into s bar minus z bar plus z bar into s minus z over s minus z into s minus z bar. We have a property of this. If we have z into z bar, then we can write it as z ka square. So we write it as s minus z mod ka square, and s into s mod, by multiplying it, we have these values. By the property of conjugate, we have s into s bar is equal to s bar square, and z into z bar is equal to z bar square. Similarly for this, just put the values of s into s bar and z into z bar. We have s bar square minus z bar square. As we know that s bar is equal to e iota phi and z is equal to r e iota theta. Similarly, in denominator, we will put the value of s and z. E raised to power iota phi is equal to cos phi plus iota sin phi whole square minus r into e cos theta plus iota sin theta whole square. Similarly, by using Euler theorem, we have e raised to power iota phi cos phi plus iota r sin phi minus r into cos theta plus iota r sin theta. As we know that z is equal to x plus iota y, then z modulus is equal to under root x square plus y square. When we'll take square on both sides, then we have z mod square is equal to x square plus y square. So just by using this, we can write it as cos square phi plus sin square phi minus r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. Denominator, cos phi minus r sin phi plus sin phi minus r sin, sin phi minus r sin theta. By combining the real part and imaginary part, we have this equation. So we have cos square phi plus sin square phi is 1 minus r square, and cos square theta plus sin square theta 1. Similarly, इन डिनोमिनेटर वी हैव कॉस फाइव माइनस आर कॉस थीटा होल स्केयर प्लस साइन फाइव माइनस आर साइन थीटा होल स्केयर. जस्ट ओपन द स्केयर ऑफ दीज टू वैल्यूज वी हैव दिस एंड दिस. सो कॉस स्केयर फाइव प्लस साइन स्केयर फाइव प्लस आर स्केयर कॉस स्केयर थीटा एंड साइन स्केयर थीटा माइनस टू आर कॉस फाइव कॉस थीटा एंड साइन फाइव साइन थीटा. सो कॉस स्केयर फाइव एंड साइन स्केयर फाइव इज इक्वल टू वन प्लस आर स्केयर इट इज ऑल्सो वन माइनस टू आर एंड इट इज द फार्मूला ऑफ कॉस कॉस बिकॉज कॉस अल्फा माइनस बीटा इज इक्वल टू कॉस अल्फा कॉस बीटा प्लस साइन अल्फा एंड साइन बीटा. सो वी कैन राइट इट इन कंबाइंड फॉर्म एज कॉस फाइव माइनस थीटा. सो नाउ जस्ट वी विल पुट द वैल्यू इन द प्लेस ऑफ दिस. वी हैव एफ ऑफ जी इज इक्वल टू वन ओवर टू पाई जीरो टू टू पाई एफ ऑफ एस इज इक्वल टू इरेस्ट पर योटा फाइव एंड दिस वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू वन माइनस आर स्केयर ओवर वन प्लस आर स्केयर माइनस टू आर कोस फाइव माइनस थीटा. सो एफ ऑफ एस इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ बाउंड्री. सो यू ऑफ आर थ्री आर फाइव वेयर आर इज इक्वल टू वन फाइव वी कैन राइट इट एज यू नोट ऑफ फाइव. सो यू आर ऑफ थीटा इज इक्वल टू वन ओवर टू पाई जीरो टू टू पाई यू नोट ऑफ फाइव डॉट वन माइनस आर स्केयर ओवर वन प्लस आर स्केयर माइनस टू आर कोस फाइव माइनस थीटा डी फाइव विच इज पॉइजन इंटीग्रल फार्मूला फॉर द यूनिट सर्कल. एंड द क्वांटिटी वन माइनस आर स्केयर ओवर वन प्लस आर स्केयर माइनस टू आर कोस फाइव माइनस थीटा वी राइट इट एज पी ऑफ आर थीटा एंड पी ऑफ आर थीटा इज कर्नल फंक्शन. सो वी कैन राइट द अबव इक्वेशन एज यू ऑफ आर थीटा इज इक्वल टू वन ओवर टू पाई जीरो टू टू पाई यू नॉट ऑफ फाइव एंड वी कैन रिप्लेस दिस बाय पी ऑफ आर थीटा. वी हैव एंगल फाइव माइनस थीटा एंड डेट पर वी कैन राइट एंगल इन स्पाइट ऑफ थीटा फाइव माइनस थीटा. सो P of r theta is referred as Poisson kernel, so we can write the equation as U of r theta 1 over 2 pi 0 to 2 pi P of r theta and U naught of phi d phi. So by using the Dirichlet problem along a circle, we describe the kernel, Poisson kernel formula and Poisson formula.